Hello there, peoples. And before we begin, I know I am super late on this, but the original video I shot for this had to get scrapped, and then I didn't have time to go re-record it. It was a mess, but I'm finally back. I finally am able to record a new version of this. So we are going to be looking at all of the reveals that happened at the Nova Open last Wednesday, and we got some pretty interesting stuff in here. So first thing first, there's no Titanicus stuff, which kind of made me sad, but can't have everything. So, starting with 40K, I'm not going to like cut away or anything because I've already watched these videos, but we have this new Psychic Awakening thing that was teased a while back. We have a new campaign of some sort, and every army is getting new rules, and there's probably going to be some sort of obviously psychic thing involved because that's what the thing is called, Psychic Awakening. So, it's going to be interesting to see how non-psychic armies play into this, like Corn and knights and stuff like that. That's gonna be very interesting to see how those play out. Also, Talon Necrons, but we'll have to see how things go, and it's gonna be interesting, especially and just in general, the campaign is gonna be interesting. So that is looking cool. Oops, I accidentally clicked something. Some models you will not believe. We are finally getting some plastic Howling Banshees, so all the Aspect Warriors for Eldar, it looks like they're finally getting some new models, which I'm pretty sure is going to make Eldar players happy and probably make everybody shut up that only Marines are getting new things, which I will admit, even though I'm a Marine fanboy, I am a little annoyed that no other faction is getting as much love. Because, I mean, come on, every faction deserves some love, even Tau and Death Guard. So, yeah, so that's interesting to see. But then we do get more Space Marines in the fact that Shrike is getting a Primaris model. Now, the whole transforming into a Primaris Marine thing. If the process would save a important figure's life, I understand it. But otherwise, don't completely mess with the original character. It just the prime like just feels like they're forcing things onto like characters that they don't need to. And normally I don't swear in videos that I don't throw the profanity warning up in, but I'm just gonna say this, like Kalgar, Khan, and Tigerius and Shrike all becoming randomly Primaris Marines, that's a bunch of bullshit. Like I'm sorry, but I'm a newer player. I like the Primaris Marines. I understand their purpose. That being said, they should not replace the original Marines because the Primaris Marines are more like they are more specialized in a couple of roles, whereas tactical Marines and all the older styles of Marines are much more flexible. So there are uses for each of them, but Primaris Marines should not replace regular Marines. And hopefully there's like some campaign thing that's coming out where Gulliman becomes overzealous, tries to replace everything with Primaris Marines, realizes he can't, and then goes back and then brings back a bunch of new stuff for the older style of Marines just to keep the army flexible. So I know I got off on a rant there, but I'm just annoyed as to how like GW is doing this because these classic characters who have been known for not being Primaris are all of a sudden Primaris, and I don't like it one bit. And I can only hope that they don't do the same thing for the Dark Angels heroes because that would piss me off to no extent. So, albeit the model, I will admit, despite what I just said, the model does actually look pretty cool. I wish it had a helmet though, so maybe there's an option there. Moving on, we have in some new Necromunda gang, and this one seems to look different, at least from the video, because look, from what I understand, all the other gangs follow some sort of code in terms of not doing certain things, but whatever these guys are, they just want flesh and blood and violence all over the place. So it's gonna be interesting to see how this pans out, but honestly, I'm probably not gonna pay attention too much to it since really, the only two things I care about for Necromunda are the Enforcers and House Dallak. So, unless, of course, these guys have some really cool weapons. But I don't play Necromunda, but I do want to one day. Moving over to Middle Earth, I'm going to skip over this quickly just because I don't play it. But we're getting a new supplement, or you're getting a new supplement. There's a new scenery piece, a couple of Saruman models. Okay, Warcry. So, Warcry, we're getting a new supplement that focuses on monsters and mercenaries. And actually, when I'm recording this, I'm recording this on the Sunday that this an was announced that it was going to go up for pre-order. So September 7th, you'll be able to pre-order this, and basically it allows you to have specific heroes and all sorts of beasts and stuff like that. So it's going to be interesting to see how that plays out. Hopefully, maybe there's some Seraphon stuff in there, because if you've watched any of my videos where I mention Age of Sigmar, you know how much I love Seraphon. So, speaking of Age of Sigmar, we have a new faction, the Ossiarch Bone Reapers, which are sort of like, which are sort of a revamp of the Tomb Kings. So, you see that classic Egyptian skeletal kind of design in, like, the forms of, like, the shields and some of the iconography. But it looks like they've also slightly mixed with, like, a Roman style of things. So, like, this helmet right here definitely looks Roman. And then also looks like they took some inspiration from the Necrons. So, overall, it just creates a really intimidating sort of model, and I actually really like it. So, we have some cavalry here as well. More of the Roman mixed with Egyptian-style theming and more Necron-style theming. We have this one especially screams Necron to me, especially the head. So, this model is actually pretty cool. We have these General Grievous-style elite troops with, like, four swords or two two-handed swords. These are really cool. We have some sort of walking catapult thing that reminds me of the artillery that the clones used at the Battle of Geonosis in Attack of the Clones. So, this is kind of cool. And it also probably is somewhat reminiscent of the old Screaming Skull catapults from Fantasy. So, definitely nice to see something like that return. And then we have a new Mortark in, what's his name, Katakros. The Mortark of the Necropolis, I think it is. I'm not 100% sure, but this model does actually look pretty cool. And again, we see more of that Roman and Egyptian detailing there. So that's really cool. So honestly, if I were to ever play a Death faction, the Ossiarch Bone Reapers would definitely be the one. So that is very cool. And just a couple more things here. Warhammer Heroes is getting restarted again. Underworlds is getting a World Championships. Warhammer Legends, more 40k models and some Age of Sigmar models are going to get points in that, but the points are going to stay permanent, so once they get a point value, that's it. They're never going to be changed again. So that's going to be nice, and it's especially nice for me because I have the old Imperial Space Marine model that they have right here, as well as the Oxoldo and Ted and Helen models from Fantasy that I got when they were up for made to order. So, and then we have some news on Angels of Death. They've been working on concept art, a couple of images, and then the Sisters of Battle, let's just call them that. They're getting a special army set that contains the codex for the army as well as 25 models, and these are pre-painted. So you're gonna be this is what they're gonna be like. So you get some standard battle sisters, some seraphim. A penitent engine, as well as possibly this new canonist that was given out to Nova attendees, at least for the Warhammer preview. But it's nice to see that after all these years, GW starting things off with a pretty unprecedented thing for them. So this is really cool to see. And even though I've never really paid attention to Sisters, this is definitely nice to see for the people who have really been waiting for this for years. So that's really everything that that happened at Nova. I know this was a shorter video, but there really wasn't too much to talk about. So that'll do it for this video. And the next video will most likely be me speculating on the new Clone Wars stuff for Armada that we're going to be getting at sometime at the end of next year. So that'll do it. Peace out.